This is the leaderboard. This is how they go into the start with all square on points between the Australians and the Japanese, but the Australians have more victories. In fact, the Japanese haven't won yet here in Miami, so Belcher and Ryan have the slightest of advantages. But the top nine can all win medals mathematically. So a lot more breeze there on the screen. 2 minutes to go to the start. What's changed?
So we've seen a big shift move round towards that right-hand side from the race course, and this pressure started to come up. We were saying that that heat started to stall it, whether this is the first part of, you know, they were talking about the forecast coming in slightly earlier. Now the temperatures, because it went really hot in that sort of last little bit just as we were breaking out there. So that breeze being up a little bit more. So we have, as you see, eight and a half, up to nine knots of wind speed. So a superb breeze. Looking up there from the drone shot, you can start to see those darker patches, that breeze becoming more identifiable for the sailors. But again, with that shifting round, suddenly you have to reset, start taking in all your numbers again, and it becomes a totally different race course. But some big patches of breeze coming down, and that's what all the sailors are going to try and tap into.
So a minute to the start, and Belcher and Ryan of Australia now in the centre of the fleet, in the middle of the start line there, with their nearest challengers, Okada Okazono of Japan, just to their right-hand side. Which way would you go, Evie?
Conditions have completely changed. There's about 8 to 9 knots, and there used to be a bias in that first race with the women, but now actually the starting line is completely even. There isn't really an advantage this side, so it'll definitely be the side on which the first puff is coming. It's hard for us to judge sitting in the studio.
But look at them all bunched up on that right-hand side.
Yeah, but as we can see from our numbers, there isn't... Yeah, at the moment, actually, it's a 12-meter... port hand side advantage, so that's the pin end, which is rather strange, and everybody's bulking up at that top.
Now, the Australians, our overall leaders, are over on this left-hand side of the line. Everyone else seems to be bunched up at the top end. But the men are away in the 470 medal race. The climax of a week of racing here on Biscayne Bay, and it's a great start for Matt Belcher and Will Ryan on the near side of the screen.
Interesting. They looked like they were dipped by the line, and as they came off by the pin end, they had a really good solid way of starting, because they could see where that pin end was, but it looked like there was a little bit of a bulge in that center part of the start. I heard a second signal, and I felt there might be an OCS sort of flying around that.
I can tell you it's confirmed. It's Stuart McNay and David Hughes of the USA.
So, because there was that sort of a middle bunch in the middle, really sort of poking out a little bit early, went sort of a couple of seconds early. And certainly for some of the boats either end, you've got a real fixed point, a nice way to transit off and be able to define where you are on that start line. But you can see that breeze is up, because now the crews are working. Now the crews can come into this pumping zone.
So the Americans then, OCS. The Americans are looking for points as their qualification battle continues within the USA team to represent the team at Tokyo 2020. Not a huge disaster for McNay and Hughes, because they are well ahead of their nearest teammates at the moment. But Doi and Kimura of Japan are out in front right now. Good enough for a bronze medal position. Doi and Kimura started the day sixth overall, so going well.
So look at that, a real split from the fleet. So four boats out towards that right-hand side. So it shows how this race course is already being a totally different track to what we saw in the 470 women. So very different opinions. But again, the Australians really committed towards this left-hand side. So we've got the breezes fairly even across the race course. Maybe I'd say there's a bit more breeze towards that right-hand side of the course. This breeze starting to filter out a little bit on that left. So they're going to certainly rely on a left-hand shift to be able to come back in on that port tack to keep up with these other boats. So a little bit of a speed advantage to the boats on that right.
Kazuto Doi and Noya Kimura of Japan with the number 8 on their bow. and the best placed of the two Japanese teams at the moment. Not overall, but in this race as things stand. Belcher and Ryan out in front. Long way to go still in this race.
Yeah, but I have the feeling Belcher and Ryan, they're the boat most towards us, all the way on the left. And looking at the numbers, they're definitely going the fastest of everyone. And they were in second, third position, but have now claimed the first position. And I think they'll just go all the way and then just go for the latest tech.
Yep, and I think that they've
probably just tech. Yeah, that's them right now. I think they're just going to cross all the way towards that top mark and just play that left-hand side. And I'm pretty sure that the left-hand side is going to be the favorite side of this first leg.
So the leading boat's hitting 6 knots right now. The wind just under 9 knots at the moment. So it has kicked in. We feared, really, when we saw it drop off and die at the end of the women's 470 medal race. But as we explained earlier, they moved the course. They've found an area of the bay where the breeze is still good. Will Ryan working hard on the boat.
It's at that real stage now, and this is where you know, the world-class teams really show their performances, that in these marginal conditions where they've got to work so well and so synchronized together with powering up the boat, using every little gust that comes through. As you just picked up, Will sort of working hard on that wire, just doing any kinesthetic to kind of really kind of drive through the rig, keep that power going. And there you can see it there as a perfect example, not actually even clipped in on the harness. So just using his whole body weight hanging will drop into that rest period. But while doing that, the rig's moving in a certain way. So Matt's having to tune right into exactly that. And so that's where they become a very tuned in crew together.
Both men very fit. Will Ryan incredibly fit. Always seeing him go off after... quite often after racing for a long cycle ride. The preparation and the work never ends. It's not just happening on the water. McNay and Hughes, top of the screen there, the top of the graphic, are faded out because they were OCS. They started too early. They crossed the line before the clock hit zero, and so they are eliminated from the race because they didn't turn around and start again. Jammer and Rodriguez... of Spain, doing the business right now in second place and holding on to the silver medal position. They started the day fourth overall. So another good performance from the Spanish, who are always there or thereabouts in the medals.
Yeah, and it's really exciting. I think the teams are really close together. Belcher and Ryan were the boat furthest on the left, but they were not in a controlling position. So if the wind is going to turn a little bit towards the right, they might lose that first position. As you can see it on the image, the boats that are a little bit more in the middle of the screen might have the advantage. And I think, yeah, Belcher and Ryan just lost their first place over there.
Interesting battle going on in fourth and fifth between the Japanese pairs. Okada and Hokozono still in the hunt for gold here in Miami. So we are at the top mark, and it's the Spanish who round it in first place. Okada and Hokozono in second. Belcher and Ryan round in third. So not quite the advantage we thought they would have had.
Yeah, I think they overdid it a little bit. They went to the left, but they didn't have the advantage to tech first, so they were a little bit on top, but not in a controlling position. And from the moment there's a little bit less breeze or the wind shift a little bit towards the right, you are really losing that advantage. And that's exactly what happened to them.
As soon as you're committed to one side, you are instantly minimizing some of the options. They came out off that port end looking good, held that breeze. There's this breeze looking at when we sort of tune in on the analytics, you can see the breeze, the wind streamlets coming down in different colors on the side of the race course, and you can see them filter in, and suddenly one side of the race course gains quite a bit more breeze. There's quite a noticeable sort of knot, 2 knots more breeze, and then suddenly it filters back out. So it's about staying into those, and if you're unable to to move in and out of those phasing pressures, then you are committed to one side. At some point, you're going to be going slightly slower, and that's where they've been caught out.
Yeah, I think that definitely the left side paid off, but it was just all about that right momentum to take that tack and to cross towards the other side. And I think the two other teams, Xamar and Okada and Hokazona, just did that a little bit better, and that's where they took their advantage.
But right now, it's the Catalan and the Galician out in front on that Spanish boat and in control of this race. But there's still a long way to go. We're approaching the halfway stage as they head towards that downwind mark. You can see how hard they're working. Keeping a control of that spinnaker.
Yeah, and also here we can see that there's not a lot of difference in tactics and strategy between the teams. Everybody's more or less following that same trail down, choosing that right-hand side, looking downwards, because the wind is just a little bit more in that angle, and it's all about keeping the boat going and going into that jibe at the right moment.
Well, Okada and Okazono currently sitting in second place. That's good enough to win here in Miami. They've already been selected to represent Japan at Tokyo 2020, and it'll be their first Olympic Games. So they are really building towards some massive attention at their home Olympic Games in a few months' time.
Just about to say, what a shot there. It really gives you an idea of where that race course is, but also that drone shot, looking down at the boats and how much they're working and how much it's got to all come in together. Huge weight going in. A lot of them actually little bits of tuning up and just keeping that guy in the same place and working that rig all the time. So as I say, lots of people always had that feeling of sailors would get round that windward mark and then it was time to relax a little bit, put a spinnaker up and let it all go downwind. Actually now that's completely the opposite. It's if not that tempo just now continues. And certainly with two people in the boat, such as the 470, the tempo, the timing, the synchronization of it is vital. They're looking good here for Belcher and Ryan. They're sat on the inside there. You've got the Japanese on the far shot, but you can see the teamwork and the movement going in between the sailors and how they're positioning themselves. Coming into the gate mark.
And it'll be interesting to see because they're choosing a different gate, Okada and Hokazona and Belcher and Ryan. So it'll be interesting to see how that's going to play out in that first part of that second beat.
Yeah, perfect split. They rounded that at exactly the same time. We look up when you can see a pretty square course from where that windward mark was positioned. Emma and Rodriguez taking that little tack back to come back across towards the middle to put a little bit of a cover on the Japanese pair that have gone out towards that right-hand side. But again, you can see that breeze and the patches across that race course, and that's what they've got to pick their way up win.
So the whole fleet around, heading upwind for the second and final time, and still the Spanish out in front, but Belcher and Ryan closing in on them. And so close between these three. Now, Dahlberg and Bergstrom, who started the day third overall, are back in sixth. But they also are very experienced. A number of Olympic Games to their names. Can they use that experience to work their way back up the fleet? Remember, they were holding on to the bronze medal going into today's race. So the just looking at the way the fleet are sort of ranged across across the course here, and mostly all on that right-hand side. with Ocado and Hokozono here, centre of camera, second place and holding on to gold.
Yeah, it looks quite even to me, actually. It's not like the wind is turning greatly towards the left-hand side or towards the right-hand side. There's not a lot of pressure differences, I would say. I would actually think that the right gate, looking downward, was the best gate, but you just had to take that right moment to cross to the other side. And I have the feeling that Belcher and Ryan didn't have the best crossing. They were going a little bit lower in the beginning of that right-hand right-hand tack. But let's wait a little bit and let's see how this is going to unfold. I think they're playing cat and mouse now at the top of the screen there on the right. But at the moment, it's Doi and Kimura that are also doing actually really well all the way on the left side. So they're the first boat here. If you look at the screen, the first boat down at the bottom, all the way left. And at the moment, the wind is at 310, so a little bit in that left-hand side, but it's too early to say whether or not that's really going to pay off because they're so far apart at the moment. Oh. It's a long shot, I would say.
Doi and Kimura on this left-hand side, hugely experienced. We've been seeing Doi competing in the World Cup Series for almost 7 years. Since 2013, he made his debut in the series. Yet to win a medal race, but has several bronzes to his name in the years that he's been competing in the World Cup Series.
Well, this is it. Now the tacks come in. Look at the position. Good wind over towards this side that we can see. Good pressure, a bit of white cap sort of coming out on that sort of from that boat. Good driving speed.
Going 2-3 knots faster.
And they've tapped into the resource on that left-hand side. So sat in a really strong position and really fighting it out. This could spin the tables upside down on the boats that have been battling in that ride. Really put that pressure on sort of Belcher and Ryan. You can see them just slipping back and just trying to find a clean lane, trying to find that little bit of speed. And get back into the groove here. But as we see, look on that leaderboard, they have dropped straight off that top six boat. So real pressure on the Australians.
Yeah, I think a lot more pressure on that left-hand side, but also the wind has shifted down to 305. So definitely more breeze and a favorable shift on the left-hand side. And I'm pretty sure that Doi and Kimura, as things stand, will be rounding that mark in first position, as they have about a 20-meter lead over Xamar and Rodriguez.
Luke Patience and Chris Groob of Great Britain started ninth overall, currently sitting in fourth in this medal race. Potentially, mathematically, they could snatch a bronze medal. But at the moment, Doi and Kimura have done all they can.
Yeah, I think
to
we'll see
take
them
a medal and finish on the podium.
We'll see them shortly, I think, into play. Because here we see Xamar and Okada and, Doi and Kimura are approaching from the complete other side, but I'm pretty sure they will cross just in front. And there they are.
So Doi and Kimura started the day sixth overall, have moved their way up the fleet into first place and into the bronze medal position. A great performance from the experienced Japanese. Chama and Rodriguez of Spain now in second. The other Japanese, Okada and Hokozono, round in third. Here come Patience and Groob. And still no movement up the fleet for Dahlberg and Bergstrom. They had their hands on a medal overnight, but that is slipping away as the fleet heads off downwind. The final leg, we've got a short reach, final few meters at the bottom gate, but time is running out for Dahlberg and Bergstrom to close the gap and try and work their way up the fleet for a medal. Okada and Hokozono currently sitting third.
This comes back to pretty much what we were talking about, sort of who's going to take medals at the Games, who's going to come away with this. Well, this shows the depth in this fleet. It really does shake it up that they were so tight on points coming into this race. And straight away, the actual podium places have already chopped and changed and are changing in front of our eyes. It's an amazing race, but it does show the depth that's within this fleet. And anyone could go away with a medal.
And you can see how the leaders are now pulling away from the rest of the fleet. That third place still wide open. Can the Spanish catch the leading Japanese? It is so close.
Hey, this breeze staying strong at sort of 9.5. Not still sort of in around 3:15. 3:10, so fairly consistent, and you can see the whole fleet all jiving now onto port, and just again now it's become a bit more of a speed race again with that sort of shift round. It's all going to be about technique, speed, who's got the right setup, the right kit for these conditions.
I think the Spanish team is sailing a really, really great race. They were controlling everything they could control in that second upwind. They couldn't do much about Doi and Kimura because they were just setting off to the complete opposite side of where they were battling their own little battle with the other teams. But they've now taken the lead. They took like initiative to jibe first and have passed Doi and Kimura and are showing true skills in this race.
Yeah, that early jibe positioned them really nicely, tapped into that breeze a little bit earlier. And as they sort of, now you can see them just extending out, just trying to put the pressure on the Japanese to try and close. But superb early jibe sits them in a great position.
So Chama and Rodriguez perfectly placed to claim their second ever World Cup Series victory. They won here in Miami last year. Can they make it 2 out of 2?
Yeah, it doesn't look like much can stop them at the moment. They're going a knot and a half faster than the ones that are behind them. And they're right on the right line to go to that down to that gate.
If you're just joining us, we are watching the medal races live from Bay Biscayne in Miami in the World Cup Series. And this is the second medal race of the day. France won the women's 470. And right now, the Spanish are looking good for gold in the men's race. 5 other medal races scheduled today, and the weather changing all the time, it has to be said. The wind getting up on shore now, the clouds coming in. I absolutely couldn't predict how it's going to look 5 minutes from now, let alone 5 hours from now. So Chama and Rodriguez of Spain are heading towards the finish line, just a few meters left now, and it looks like Doi and Kimura are going to take second. Okada and Hukuzono will be third. And Chama and Rodriguez celebrate their second consecutive victory at the World Cup Series in Miami. They did it in 2019. They are our winners in 2020. Celebrations on board. I asked them as they set off this morning, how's it going to go? Ah, well, I hope, he says.
And I think they're still an amazing race, really.
Doi and Kimura also have performed very well, but that second place just isn't enough to get them a medal because they were sixth overall today. Okada and Okazono will have the silver, and Belcher and Ryan, who started in that gold medal position, our world champions, have slipped to fourth and have slipped to bronze. Bronze being a great achievement, of course. It's just that we're used to watching Belcher and Ryan, you know, take away gold. It's all about context, isn't it? Mantis and Kagialis of Greece are in fifth. Patience and Grube of Great Britain, sixth. And Dahlberg and Bergstrom struggling right from the start, really. They started the day. The Swedes started the day third overall. And they're going to have to settle for seventh in this race. And we'll confirm in a little while, as soon as we can, what where the Swedes finished overall. Right, there is the site of the 470 men's fleet. They'll be heading straight back, and the race management will be keen to get away the next medal race, which is the Laser Radial. And congratulations from the Australians there to the Spanish. And there's confirmation of the results then. Chamar and Rodriguez win that race and take the gold. Okada and Okazono finish in second place overall. Belcher and Ryan third. And there you go. Dolberg and Bergstrom in the end taking fifth. So it's gold for Spain, silver for Japan, and bronze for Belcher and Ryan of Australia.